Welcome to everyone joining us. Today is about people, conversations, and action. It's about finding connection, sharing our truths, and coming together to transform our communities. That's the basis of racial healing and the source of great power at a time when so many are calling for unity and change in our society. After the divisiveness, loss, and pain of the past year, people are hungry for healing in mind, body, and spirit. At the Kellogg Foundation, we've seen how our truth, racial healing, and transformation communities have begun to heal and change their communities. You will see how, as this event unfolds, the common element is that racial healing is the first step on every path. It creates a space to acknowledge a person's story, and it begins with a conversation. Well, welcome, Storm. It's so nice to see you again. So, Storm, when we spoke at the last National Day of Racial Healing, you made a comment that caused me a great deal of pain. I remember you saying that you felt it was hard for a woman in this country, and particularly you felt that it was difficult for an African-American woman. But let me ask you, knowing that and going through this past year, what was it like for you? What was last year like for you?
There were times where I felt a lot of pain, of course. But through that pain, I did find hope. When I look at Breonna Taylor, I see my mom. When I look at Breonna Taylor, I see my aunt or my sister or my cousin. Or when I look at George Floyd, I see my father, my uncles, and my brother. So, of course, there were days where I felt like I could say so much and I wanted to say everything that was on my mind. And then other days, I felt like I couldn't summon the words to express how I felt. And then there are days and most more days than none where I'm like, okay, how do we fix this?
I think we've all connected with pain this past year. And I feel like this year was a time when we became more aware. As you were saying, we saw this pandemic and the disparities that existed and the disparate impact of this pandemic. We also saw the brutality, real life. We all had to witness these incidents. And because of that, I believe that awareness in this country was strengthened. And I've seen people show up because of that awareness. We saw those demonstrations, and we saw that there were people there from every color and every generation. And we saw how people came together in urban communities and small towns, all demanding accountability. I was very hopeful when corporate America stood up and many statements came out. But then after those statements, commitments were made. And corporate America remains engaged in this conversation. They're looking within their companies and they're standing up to be champions. In some ways, we could say, once again, our young people stood up for the values of our country. And I know you're just one young person, but how do you think young people have fared over this past year, and how are they processing this moment?
I can't speak for my entire generation, but I'm proud to say that I'm a part of a generation that is accepting, and we are the most culturally diverse generation in America right now, and we are hopeful. And we already know that Black Lives Matter, and we already know that we deserve to be seen and heard and respected. But I think it's clear that we still have a long way to go. WK Kellogg Foundation have done such amazing things to push racial healing forward and have been a part of this movement for decades. But how do you make sure that it's not something that we're just doing in the moment or to just get over the injustices, but how do we actually come together as a society and fix our core, if that makes sense?
It makes a lot of sense. The way to build new systems is to engage people, bring people together, and first of all, to allow them to heal from the centuries where you didn't have to create systems that work for everyone. But today, we can come together, and those systems can be redesigned so that every person has an opportunity to thrive within those systems. Days like this and this moment, this day of healing, is part of that process. Because when people heal and come together and share stories and create a common humanity from those stories, that's then the power by which transformation can happen. You know, every time we come together, I think I'm just inspired by your soul and the fact that, again, at such a young age, you understand your role in life and you're taking on a responsibility in that role that I just admire. And I think there are many young people like you who are doing the same thing. And so as we close this conversation, let me just ask you in one word, what are you feeling right now about the future?
After this conversation, after all of our conversations, I always feel hopeful. That's my one word. I just want to say thank you for always including me in this conversation and being in my corner as a champion and as someone I can look to for hope. So thank you.
Well, thank you. Thank you. I'm ready for the challenge ahead of us. So it's time for us to do this. And we're going to do this together. So thank you so much for your time. It is always a pleasure.
Thank you.